You know, when you started your YouTube channel, you had a lot of content creators as well as even to YouTube recommendation about how to get a click-through rate. Because when you get a click-through rate, that is CTR on your videos, that can only generate viewers, watch time hours, as well as subscribers. But the only way you can get that click-through rate is when people see your videos and click on it and then watch it through. That is click-through rate. But however, the only reason that will lead them to click that videos of yours is by having a very high catchy thumbnails. But if your thumbnail is not eye-catchy enough, that is where the problem is. Sometimes it's very difficult to get that beautiful thumbnails. You try to create, you try to put this, you try to put the features, you try to put the, or sometimes people can even just leave their videos like that without even having a thumbnails. I know it's fine, it's okay, but having a thumbnails on your videos can also help you to have a higher click-through rate. So don't worry, in today's video, I'm going to walk you through or show you the app I'm going to use on how to generate those thumbnails for you. So if you're among those who are struggling to create a thumbnails for their videos, then this video is for you. But stay tuned to the end of this video and see, because there is a bonus, I'm going to show you how to create a very realistic thumbnail that is very, very eye-catchy, that anybody that sees your videos, they will gladly click on that thumbnail to watch your videos. So let's dive into this app that I'm going to show you how to generate a beautiful contract thumbnail. So the app we're going to use in order for us to have a click-through rate thumbnail is the Leonardo app. Make sure if you haven't got one, then you need to download one and create an account of Leonardo. Click on the Leonardo Phoenix and then you come where it says type a prompt. But remember, you only have 150 points here to use. So make sure you use them very wisely. So now you come to type your prompt on how to create your beautiful thumbnail. So I will type in, I want to use Leonardo AI to create a thumbnail image for YouTube video about thumbnail tutorial for beginners. And then you give it another prompt. I want the thumbnail to be eye-catchy and Leonardo AI logo, Leonardo for beginner. Then you give it another prompt. Can you help me with this prompt? Please make it 16 by 9, as this is the YouTube standard. So let's see. Let's type go and see what do we have here. Okay, this is what we have, which is good. So if you like this, you can download it by using the download app. You check the next one. That doesn't look as well. You have another 130 points there. You still have remaining 130 points. If you think that these images or these thumbnails is not that great enough for you, you can always change your wording, see how you can make it look contrast, or maybe remove the word AI, the logo. Let's see. Let me change something here. Let me say I'll remove the Leonardo logo and just leave the text. Let me start it again. I want to use Leonardo AI to create a thumbnail image for YouTube video about thumbnail tutorial for beginners. I want the thumbnail to be eye-catchy and features text Leonardo AI for beginners. Can you help me with this? So let's see, because the logo, I didn't see the logo of Leonardo. So
This is what we have here. Let's see. Let's check out one by one. And let's see this other one. Okay, it got a writing. I think this is okay. Let's see the other one. And this one doesn't look bad either. But I think I'll go for the second one. I don't know. What do you think, viewers? Okay, so this is how you generate thumbnail using the Leonardo. So you can play around it to see how much you can make out of it. You change the wording, you can change color or contrast, whatever you want your thumbnail to become. But for me, I think I prefer the plain one. So now you've got your thumbnail. So it's up to you now to either you use this one you've already have, or you can continue to generate more because you still go about 110 points. So the bonus I'm going to teach you now, because this doesn't leave this like this. If you want, you can just use this Leonardo thumbnail that has been created for you. You can still use this one. But better still, you can maximize it by using another app. So the other app I'm going to show you now, which is the bonus one. So let's dive in and go straight to the other app to maximize the thumbnail that we are going to use. So you come off Leonardo. So the app we're going to use now is the CapCut. So we're going to use the CapCut now to beautify that your thumbnail you've already created. So now you go to new project. You check for which one you're going to use. I think I prefer this one because it looks more plain. You can add more features on this one. So how do you generate a thumbnail using the CapCut? So you go to add. And first of all, you need to make it 16 by 9. So where do you go? You go to aspect ratio and you click the 16.9 and you say okay. If you want, you can expand it by clicking on the picture and you expand it. You expand it to be much bigger. So this is how you want it. Now you can add your features on it. So you've already got the Leonardo AI for beginners. Now I'm going to add in some features, which first of all, I'm going to put in my own facial. So it depends whatever features you want to add. So for me, I'm going to put in my facial expression. So you go to overlay. From overlay, you click on add overlay. So I'm going to find what pictures I'm going to use. So from here, take the picture. I'm going to remove the background picture because it will make it look nice if you leave the picture like that without removing the background. So background remove, click OK. So I'm going to resize it to where I want it to be. So I'm gonna make it stand this way. Would that be okay? So wherever you want your picture to be, which is okay. So I think here is better because I don't want it to come to the middle. I think here will be a better position. So you click out of the video, voila. So this is it. So now, if you want to add the Leonardo logo, this is the time for you to add it. Remember, when we use the Leonardo app, it couldn't give us the logo. So now we go to overlay. Okay, this is the app. You go to add, and I'm going to remove the background for that as well. Up to background. So say it okay, and you resize it to what you wanted it to be. I think I'm going to leave it at the bottom here, or better still, I'll put it at the middle here. So since I'm using CapCut as well, I think we do need CapCut as well here because we are using two apps to create this thumbnail. So we've got the Leonardo app. So now let's go for the CapCut one. CapCut one, you know, CapCut, you can get it from CapCut. So let's just go to start. We go to text. you click on sticker. From sticker, you can type in here, you can type in CapCut. And then you see a lot of logos coming here. So you can choose which one you want. I think I'll prefer this one, is much brighter. So voila. So you click OK. Click OK. You resize it to what you want. I think here is much better. You know what? I think I need to remove Leonardo where it is. The Leonardo, because it's covering the four. Yeah, I think I'll put it here. Otherwise, it covers the word for Leonardo AI for beginners. So now you put the app at the bottom. I think this is the best place to put it. So it depends. Wherever you want to put your app is up to you. Wherever you want to make your layout, that's absolutely fine.
You know, the bonus as well included, you know, sometimes when you use a Leonardo, it doesn't give you a lot of features like the way you want to design it plainly. So you can use both Leonardo as well as the CapCut. So I'm going to show you the bonus on how to use generate a thumbnail using the CapCut. So if you click on the app CapCut, and then you go to new project, this time around, you're going to find a plain background to create a new thumbnail for yourself. So the background here is already 16:9. So what you do, you go to text, you go to add text, you type in whatever you want to type, what the title of your thumbnail you want it to be. For me, I'll just keep it simple as thumbnail for beginners. I think I'll leave it that way, resize it. So the next thing you need to do, you go to style, you choose the style you want it. I will use the most bright color. Remember, thumbnail has to be contrast, high catchy. So I'll use the yellow and black. So, and then I won't leave it just like that because that doesn't look bright or it doesn't look good for me. So now I'll go to the font. I'm looking for bold. Click. So this is bold. I want it to be bold. I'll use the bold C. So now it's more brighter. So I'll enlarge it a little bit and then move it at the top wherever you want your title, your thumbnail title to be. So I think it's better there. So now you got your title, your text. So the next thing I'm going to do now is to add my picture. So you go to overlay. Add overlay, looking for the most exciting picture. I think this looks okay. Look at my facial expression. That looks funny, isn't it? So I add it there. Go to remove background, auto background. I remove the background, click OK. Now I want it in the middle. So you just walk around the video, your picture, where you want it to be. I think I better like it there. So you don't just leave it there. So you can add some features. It's up to you, whatever you want to add. Since I use the app CapCut, so I'm going to look for CapCut. So go to text, go to sticker, type in CapCut. Okay, use this one. Put it at the side here. And then I'll type in again, say, okay. I want YouTube logo as well to be on it. This time around, I'll choose this. Put it on the other side of the picture. So as simple as that. So you can add whatever you want to add on your thumbnail, whatever you want to add on it. For me, I'll just, since it's a tutorial, I just want to leave it as simple as it is. So when you are satisfied with what you want, you can add as many features as you want. But for me, I like my thumbnail to be very, very simple so that it can be eye-catchy. So now you screenshot.
and you export. Remember, you can add as many features as you can. This is just a simple tutorial how to create a thumbnail. Export. Remember, you click done. Go to your gallery. Look for the one that you screenshot. Go to the pencil. And then you crop the picture, both bottom and top. And save. So voila, this is how you create thumbnail using the CapCut only. You've got a lot of features when using the CapCut. So this is it.
So now you see the two apps. You saw the bonus one and as well as the one I've just showed you how to create your thumbnails. So if you download these two apps on your mobile phone, this can generate a beautiful thumbnail. So you can use either the Leonardo AI as well as the CapCut to generate a beautiful thumbnails of yours. But make sure when you're putting your features, especially your pictures, your facial expression, make sure you indicate a very lovely facial expression that when people see your facial expression, that will make them love them, that will push them to click on that thumbnail. Make sure your facial expression indicates what the title of your thumbnail is saying. So make sure you give those beautiful facial expression on your thumbnail. That can only make people become very curious to see what is in this thumbnail, what is in this video. They see your title, they see your thumbnail, as well as they saw your facial expression. That can lead them to click on that video, say, oh, what is this content creators? The way the facial expression shows, that means this is a very exciting video. So I must see this video. So bring them along for them to watch you through that video. So let me know in the comment section below if you find this content very useful, and please don't forget to hit the like button and turn the notification button on so that each time I upload any of this new video, you will be the first person to know. And please subscribe for more tips to come your way. I'll see you on the next video. Take care and I love you all. Bye. Bye.